In the last part of our series on the aftermath of the 1980 election that plunged the country into war, we'll look at the post-war career of Yoweri Museveni, who sputtered come third in the polls after he successfully waged a five-year people's war. After capturing state power in January 1986, Museveni moved to form a broad-based government that included the political forces in the country, while political party activities were suspended and restricted to their headquarters. Later that year, insurgents in the north started by remnants of the disbanded army. Later, Alice Lakwena formed her Holy Spirit movement, which was to be succeeded by Joseph Kony's Lord's Resistance Army. But Museveni also faced a serious challenge of Kenya, whose business community and political leaders were worried that recovering Uganda spelled disaster of their manufacturing and transport sector that depended heavily on the Ugandan market. The two countries almost went to war in December 1987. The NRM pledged to stay in power for 4 years and organize general elections. The clock ticked very fast, and January 1990 was approaching for the NRM term to end to give way to an elected government. The Museveni government brought a motion to the interim legislature, which was chaired by Moses Chigonga's speaker on behalf of NRM chairman Yoweri Museveni, seeking a five-year extension in order to restore constitutional rule. As some members debated against the move, a historical NRC member, Gertrude Unjua, told them that the National Resistance Army had set up the NRC to formalize its wishes, and if the NRC didn't pass the extension, the NRA would still go ahead and do it. The extension was granted alongside an extension to the life of the legislature. Laws of making a new constitution were passed, including a constitutional commission of collecting people's views and writing the draft, setting up an interim electoral commission, and creating the Constituent Assembly. In October 1995, the new constitution was promulgated. During the extension, Museveni's government achieved big steps in the economy, which got liberalized and privatized. Museveni also played the leading role in reviving the East African cooperation with his then counterparts Ali Hassan Mwinyi and Arab Moi of Tanzania and Kenya respectively, that led to the creation of the current East African Community. In 1995, Uganda's first ever direct presidential elections were held, and Museveni stood. His main challenger was Paulo Semugerere. Museveni won. Semugerere's chief campaign manager, Mariam Tagamba, crossed to Museveni's camp and became minister. In 2001, the second direct presidential elections were held. Museveni offered his candidature for the last time under the constitution, which barred anybody who had served two terms from standing. His main challenger was Dr. Kizza Besigye, a Bushwa comrade and former personal physician. Museveni won. Besigye petitioned the Supreme Court but lost on grounds that the irregularities in the elections were not enough to change the outcome of the election. In 2005, the constitution was amended by Parliament to remove the presidential term limits. This cleared the way for Museveni to seek presidency again. He stood in 2006, and his main challenger was again Dr. Kizza Besigye. Museveni won and Besigye petitioned the Supreme Court. Although court found several irregularities, including the Electoral Commission failing to follow the law in conducting the election, the petition was dismissed. In 2011, Museveni stood again and his main challenger was again Besigye. It was a peaceful election, but a lot of money was used, leading to inflation. Bank of Uganda Governor Tumusiime Mutebure protested in the foreign press. Museveni won again. This time, Besigye did not petition court, saying he no longer expects justice from the country's judiciary. Instead, he joined walk-to-work protests that almost crippled the economy. He was assaulted several times and pepper sprayed, getting hospitalized in Nairobi and narrowly surviving going blind. In 2016, Museveni stood again. A new entrant in the race was his longtime colleague, Amama Mbabazi, who had also been Secretary General of the NRM and Prime Minister. New key players like Evelyn Anite came in on Museveni's side to neutralize Mbabazi's clout in the party. He was ejected from the executive. The campaign was tense, attempts to unite Mbabazi and Besigye failed, and in the end, Museveni won with Besigye again coming in as runner-up. Mbabazi couldn't even garner 1.5% of the total votes cast. In 2017, the presidential candidate age limit of 75 years was removed from the constitution, paving way for Museveni to keep standing if he wishes. The amendment was passed under unprecedented tension and violence in parliament. Security forces entered the chamber and fought with opposition legislators, inflicting several injuries on some of them, and they had to be treated in different, healthy facilities. A new opponent emerged in the process. A young musician turned MP, Robert Chagulanyi, also known as Bobby Wine. Subsequent by-elections and elections to new constituencies have since become a battle between Chagulanyi and Museveni. The next presidential election is scheduled for 2021, and Museveni is likely to stand again, going by statements of his party members. Besigye has indicated that he may not stand, while pressure is also mounting on Chagulanyi to stand. If this happens, it will be a battle of generations. This is the end of New Vision TV's 13-part series of the election that plunged Uganda into war and how it ended up rewriting the country's history. It gives pleasure to look back in time and relate with the current proceedings. Reporting for New Vision TV, I am Rothy Naseje.